Hey, how are you? My name is Emilio, and thank you so much for joining me today. I love technology. Hopefully you love technology too, and you've got yourself a Synology NAS. I've got myself a Synology NAS. I love the Synology NAS. I use it in my personal environment, in my home lab environment. I use it in a professional business environment as well, and I absolutely love them. And this video, of course, covers notifications, setting up notifications on your Synology NAS. What if something goes wrong? What if there's some suspicious behavior on my Synology NAS? Before we do get into that, please subscribe, clicking on the button on the bell so you don't miss out on anything that's happening on in my channel. All right, so before we do get into this video, I wanna let you know about a training course that I've got about all things Synology. If you've got yourself a Synology NAS and you want to know a lot more about it, how to set it up, how to configure it, how to get the best performance out of it, how to troubleshoot it, and a whole bunch more, check out my show notes below because I've got a full length online training course that I know that you will find helpful. We're now gonna talk about email notifications, how to set them up, how to configure them, and what to sort of look out for, and the importance, of course, of a Synology NAS notification. So we're gonna log into my computer. I've now logged in via a browser to the IP address of my NAS. I've logged in as an admin, as the root user, and we're gonna show you that right now. So here we are logged into our Synology NAS. Now, notifications are super important. When your NAS has a problem, when there's an issue, with one of your hard drives, when there's an issue with the actual SAN itself, the NAS itself, it's always good for an administrator, for you who's looking after a Synology NAS, to be aware of when things are going wrong, right? So you don't want to just let the NAS do its thing and not alert you when something goes wrong. It's actually pretty inconvenient for you to have to log into your Synology NAS to find out the health of your NAS. You know, if it's rebooted, if there's a power issue, if there's a hard drive issue, it would be so much easier if the Synology NAS could itself send you a notification when something has gone wrong. Now, you can set the frequency, you can set some sort of notification settings on your NAS to let you know exactly what sort of alerts you want to get, because in some cases, you don't want to be alerted to absolutely everything, because you can essentially just get spammed with a lot of mail. And that may not be relevant for you, but you do want to know, especially when there are high and critical alerts or when something is fishy on your SAN. So let's say there's some unexpected behavior. Sometimes good for you to be able to set up those notifications so that you can see exactly what is going on. So that's the purpose of this video. We're going to go in and actually show you how to enable those notification settings so that the NAS automatically emails you or emails a team of administrators or whatever when something needs to get your attention. From here, we're gonna go into our control panel and then we scroll down to notification, okay? You can access the control panel also by going into the main menu and control panel right in there. You can also do SMS options, which is actually quite cool, but you will need an SMS provider to be able to set up username and passwords and an account essentially with them to be able to do that. But here we have our email. We're gonna enable email notification. We tick on that. Now, something you need to be aware of is the service provider itself. Now, if we click on this list down here, you've got Gmail, Outlook, QQ, and custom SMTP. So if you're doing this in a business, you've got something like Exchange, you've got another mail server type of some sort, you may commonly want to use the SMTP server. So you want to select custom SMTP server. It's going to ask you for the SMTP server address name, the IP address, or the fully qualified name, the relevant port, which of course is 465, and then you want to input some relevant username and password credentials for that. If you're using SSL, you want to add in the relevant information for there. And then once that is all done, you can then send a test email. You can also use something like Gmail, all right, which is actually really, really cool. You can actually put right into here your email address for your Gmail, and then you can click on log into Gmail and it actually will log in. So let's just say I want to do a johnsmith@gmail.com. We then click on log into Gmail. It'll open up a Gmail window where then you log in with your credentials and then it'll pass those credentials in and then you can test that account. So you may want to make your subject prefix also something customized. So you could have your IP address of your Synology NAS, which is what I've got right here, or you can actually say primary NAS notification, something similar to that. Okay, so at least I know straight away that it's coming from my primary NAS and this is a notification. If you do get a notification window like this to redirect important information to, yep, we're gonna say agree. So here's an example of the notification. You'll see that it actually says primary NAS notification test message from my Aguero Synology. and a bit more information. Dear user, congratulations. It's now set up, ready to go, and then you'll get notifications going forward. So with notifications now turned on, if you also look into the advanced area, this is actually a really good area where you can actually customize the sort of notifications that you actually want to be able to send. This could be over email, SMS, and mobile. So in the advanced area, you can have some little drop-down areas and you can see straight away, well, I've got notifications now turned on. Well, when something happens, this is the sort of notification that I want. And you've got a list of stacks, right? Alerts for absolutely everything. So you can let the NAS do its thing and standardize and give you the standard alerts and notifications that you need. Or you can go into here and specifically enable or disable types of notifications, because you don't want to get spammed with notifications on absolutely everything necessarily. You may want to customize this for exactly what you want to get notifications for. So notifications set up, done, working. Hopefully you found this helpful. If you did, please do what you do across the socials by liking, commenting, subscribing, and also check out some of my other videos if you want to learn about all things tech.